Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to start the topic ready nomenclature. As you know, this is the most important topic of the organometallic compound. If you see the previous year question paper, there were always the one question on this particular topic. So let's start the ready nomenclature. So the first step to calculate the ready nomenclature is calculate total number of electron in the given structure. For example, we are given IR4CO12. Okay, so how to calculate the total number of electrons? I have already told you in the previous videos. So one IR will give the valence electron 9, 4 are present, plus one CO will give you 2 electrons into 12. So this comes out to be 36 plus 24, which total give you 60 electrons. So our first step is completed, that is calculate total electrons. Next step is calculate x. What is x? Total electron minus n into 12 divided by 2. So this is the formula for the x. What is n here? N is the number of metals. Okay, so for this structure, total number of electrons are 60 minus n is 4. So 4 into 12 divided by 2, that is 60 minus 48 divided by 2, which is 12 by 2, which is 6. So the x comes out to be the 6. So our second step is completed, that is to calculate the x. Now compare this number with the number of metals. So the total number of metals present in the given structure are 4, and x comes out to be 6. Now what you do so that your number becomes equal to 6? You will just add the number 2. So what we have taken as the number of metal, n, what will we do? Just in place of number of metal we will put the n, right? N plus 2, this will give you the total calculated x, that is 6. So your structure comes out to be the n plus 2. Now how to check the structures? By seeing the structure in the previous example, we have found n plus 2. Now for the structure, how to check? If you see, n minus 1 give you the structure superchloroso, n equals to hyperchloroso. If n plus 1, this will give you chloroso, n plus 2 give you nido, n plus 3 will give you arachno. These three are the important structure in the ready nomenclature. However, there are others also, that is n plus 4 equal to hypo, and n plus 5 will give you clado. So in your example of IR4CO12, it comes out to be n plus 2. So n plus 2 gives you structure nido. So for this, the ready nomenclature is nido, right? We will take one more example, that is RU5NCO14, one negative, right? So the one RU will have the valence electron of 8. Okay, 8 fives are plus, N will give you how many valence electron? 5. 5 plus 1 CO will give 2, 14 will give you 14 into 2, plus there is a one negative charge. So this is 40 plus 5 plus 28 plus 1, right? So this will give you the total number, I think 28, 1, right? 14, 5, 6, 7. So this will give you the number 74. So the total electrons, first step is total number of electrons. Next, to calculate the x, that is 74 minus n, n is 5. 5 into 12 divided by 2. Okay, that is equal to 74 minus 60 divided by 2. this comes out to be 14 by 2 and x comes out to be 7. Then compare this number with the number of metals. Number of metals are 5 and x is 7. So what will you add? You will add the number 2. So in place of 5, just put the n plus 2. So n plus 2 again is the structure nido. So structure for this is nido. So as we learn how to calculate the Wedde nomenclature for the organometallic compound, but if you see in the last few years, along with the Wedde nomenclature, you were also asked the geometry of the organometallic compound. Okay, so how to calculate the geometry? There is no particular formula to calculate the geometry. You have to just remember it by the number of valence electron. So when the total electron of that compounds comes out to be 48, the geometry is triangle. When the valence electron are 60, geometry is tetrahedron. When the total number of valence electron are 72, geometry comes out to be trigonal bipyramidal. Okay, for the 74, geometry is square pyramidal. For the 84, geometry is bicap tetrahedron. For the 86, the geometry is octahedron. For the 90, geometry is trigonal prism. For the number 112, means when the valence electron comes out to be 112, geometry is square antiprism. And when the valence electron are 120, the geometry is cube. So this you have to memorize with the number of valence electron. Next comes the Wedde nomenclature for boron cluster. So what are boranes? If you see the general formula for borane, it is BnHn plus minus charge, that is X. Okay, so firstly see the nomenclature. If the structure comes out to be BnHn with charge plus 2, the structure is super hyper closo. If it is BnHn with no charge, okay, only BnHn, the structure is hyper closo, right? If the structure is BnHn with the 2 negative charge, the structure is closo. And if BnHn minus 4, the structure is nido. And for BnHn minus 6, the structure is arachno. And the last one is BnHn with negative charge of minus 8, structure is hypo. Now, how to see the structures? Firstly, take the example like B4H10. And you have to tell the Wedde nomenclature for this boron cluster. So how you will see, okay, we need BnHn means B4H4, right? Means we need 6 H positive less. Okay, what will we do? B4H10, just release 6 H positive. Structure comes out to be B4H4. With as 6H positive are released, so the charge comes out to be minus 6. So this is like this. And when you see for this Wedde nomenclature, is this is BnHn minus 6. So let's see the structure. This is BnHn minus 6 give you arachno. So the structure for this is arachno. Okay. Next example is B6H8. What you will do, just release the 2H positive. Okay, we will get B6H6 with 2 negative charge, means this is of type BnHn 2 negative. So BnHn 2 negative will give you the nomenclature closo. So the nomenclature for this is closo. So this is the way to calculate the Wedde nomenclature for the borane cluster. Okay, next comes the Wedde nomenclature for the carboranes. Carboranes means to the borane structure, now there is a one more element, that is carbon. For example, the structure is like C2, B10, H12. Okay, the carboranes are also the very important topic for the Wedi nomenclature. So this is the example of carborane, where the carbon is also included. Okay, now you have to tell the nomenclature for this particular structure. Okay, what you will do, just convert the carbon into borane type. Okay, as you know, the carbon have valence electron 4. Okay, now boron have valence electron 3 and hydrogen have 1, which means one carbon equals to pH. This will give you 4 electron, this 3 plus 1. Okay, so one carbon equals to BH unit. Convert this carbon into BH unit. Okay, there are two carbon are present, so two carbon equal to 2 BH unit, which means it is B2H2. Just replace the carbon with this B2 and H2. Okay, in place of C2 we write B2H2, B10H12. Okay, now just add the total number of boron and the hydrogens individually. So the total number of borons are 10 plus 2, 12, and the total number of hydrogens are 2 plus 12, 14. Now you know the how to calculate the Wedi nomenclature for the borane clusters. What you will do, just release 2H positive, that is B12, H12. Okay, so the charge comes out to be minus 2, as 2H positive are released. So this is of type BN, HN, minus 2. BN, HN, minus 2 will give you structure closo. So in this way, you can calculate the Wedi nomenclature for the carboranes where the element carbon is present. Oh, okay, if in place of carbon, there is any other atom which belongs to the carbon family, for example silicon, germanium, these are belong to the carbon family, so it will also have the valence electron of 4, so this also included equal to 1 BH unit. But if in place of carbon nitrogen is present, as you know, or any member of the nitrogen family like this, if among this any of the present in place of carbon, what you will do, as nitrogen have valence electron of 5, okay, 1 BH have 3 electrons, 1 hydrogen have 1, and 1 more hydrogen have 1, so total 5 electron, means 1 nitrogen equal to BH2 unit. So just replace the nitrogen with the BH units. Okay, so this is the way to calculate the Wedi nomenclature for the boron structure and the carborane structures. Okay, next comes the geometry parts for the borane structure. So if n equals to 5, what is n here is n equals to number of borane. Okay, so if n equals to 5, structure is trigonal bipyramid. For 6 it is octahedron, for 7 pentagonal bipyramidal, for 8 dodecahedron, for 9 tricap trigonal prism. This n is not the total number of electrons, these are the number of boranes. Just remember that in the previous we have calculated the total number of electron and then check the geometry. Here we just check the number of boranes and then check the geometry. For the number 10, it is bicapped square antiprism. For the 11, octadecahedron. For the 12, icosahedron. And for the number 4, it is butterfly. So these are the geometry which is related to the number of borane. Okay, now there are two more types of electron which were sometime asked. One is framework electrons and one is fragment valence electrons. So how to check the framework electrons? These will always be asked for the borane type of cluster. Okay, so how to calculate this? BH, one BH unit will give you two framework electrons. Just remember this. One BH will give you two framework electrons. So if the structure is like this, BH at 6, 2 negative. Okay, how many BH unit are present? 6. Right, one will give you 2 electrons, 6 will give you 12 electrons, plus there is a 2 negative charge, just add 2. So total number of framework electrons are 14 for this structures. Okay, if you are asked about the molecular orbital, as you know, one orbital contains 2 electrons. So for the 14 electrons, molecular orbital are 7. Right, so this is the way to calculate the framework electron. Just remember, one BH will give you 2 electrons. Next is the fragment valence electron. How to calculate the fragment valence electron? The formula is, just calculate the total number of valence electron minus 12. So this is the formula for the fragment valence electron. For example, the structure is VCO4 and you have to tell the fragment valence electron for this particular type of structure. So this will have the valence electron of 6 plus 1 will give you 2. So 4 are present, that is 8. So total 14. So total valence electron are 14. Then 14 minus 12, that is 2. So these 2 electrons are the fragment valence electron for this structure. So this is the way to calculate fragment valence electron and the framework electrons. Now the next topic which comes under Wedde nomenclature is zintl sign. So what are zintl signs? Zintl signs are the clusters of main group element where ligands are absent. Means in this structure ligands are not present. Ligands are absent. Okay, for example, structure is PB5 2-. This is the cluster. So this is the cluster of, it is a main group element and also there is a no ligand in this. So this is the zintl's ion. Now how to calculate the nomenclature for this type of compound? First step is just calculate the total valence electron. So for this, total valence electron is PB comes under carbon family. So the valence electron for PB are 4 multiplied by 5 plus 2 negative charge. So this comes out to be 22. So total number of valence electron for this structure comes out to be 22. Okay, now convert this total valence electrons into the formula. 4n plus 2 give you closo, 4n plus 4 will give you nido, 4n plus 6 will give you arachno, and 4n plus 8 give you hypo. Right, okay, so here the number is 22. What you will have to do, n are the number of main group element present. Okay, so if you see 4 into 5, that is 20, and the total valence electron are 22. What will you do? Just 4n plus 2. So your formula comes out to be 4n plus 2 for the 22, because 4 in place of n, just put the number of a main group element, that is 5 plus 2. So 20 plus 2, 22. So for this, the formula comes out to be 4n plus 2, which belongs to the structure closo. So this is a way to calculate the nomenclature for the zintl ions. So this is all about the Wedding nomenclature. In the next topic, we will study about the isolobal analogy.